Back to the Casey Anthony trial now. The prosecution is set to wrap up its arguments. She is, of course, on trial for the murder of her young daughter, Kaylee. The Florida court gathering now and will be in session in just a few minutes. You can see live pictures up there. Let's bring in former LAPD homicide detective Mark Fuhrman. Overall, Mark, your assessment of how the prosecution has done thus far?
Well, John, I like the way that they've presented this case. I like the chronological organization of the case, and I like it. And there's been a lot of criticism over overstepping some of the forensics, but I think they're just giving the jury more than they actually need. If we take away all the forensics and all the special effects, computer imaging, you still have an overwhelming circumstantial case that Casey Anthony killed her daughter, Kaylee Anthony.
To prove that, you bring in a comparison, I guess, to the Scott Peterson case that I think is kind of interesting. He is on death row for murdering his wife, and you say there was less evidence in his case.
Much less evidence, and in California, it's very difficult to actually get on death row, especially in a case like that where you don't, they don't have a cause of death in Scott Peterson's case. There was no forensics in his truck. There was no forensic evidence in his house. His conduct was actually stellar compared to Casey Anthony, and yet he's on death row on very little evidence. His fishing trip, a few other lies, missing anchors. But other than that, his case is pale in comparison to Casey Anthony.
What about, though, the mix-up in the identification of that can at the beginning, Dr. Arpad Voss? Doesn't that hurt the prosecution?
I don't think it hurts at all. Dr. Voss, I know about him. I've read about the body farm. I think it's fantastic. It's new technology. It's new ideas. And it was completely unnecessary. It was something that was given to the jury that was an extra. Every person can imagine over this the scope of the witnesses, the smell of a decomposing body is something you'll never forget and you'll never miss. Recognize it is something that you see a picture and you can conjure up the odor in your mind. So I think it's powerful. I think the jury got it. They were trying to give them more than they needed, but it's not going to hurt the case.
Well, you know from the O.J. Simpson case and many others that you've been involved with as well, the juries can do unpredictable things. Are you predicting a successful prosecution here?
I am. And if you're going to use that comparison, I think that we have to go back and see that the jury wasn't selected as it was in this case. The jury was selected to be visually and politically correct. Some points the prosecution gave up challenging the defense. And in this case, I think both sides actually did a good job picking a jury. And I do predict she's going to be guilty. I think the penalty phase for death might be a little difficult. She might walk away with life without.
Mark Fuhrman is a former Los Angeles police detective, police homicide detective. Mark, thanks.